If you're like a lot of other people right now, you're trying to bake but can't really find a lot at the store, so you want to bake with what you have. Well, here are three easy desserts with only three ingredients each. What's going on, guys? My name is AJ. Welcome back to my channel. So you heard me correct. Three desserts with only three ingredients each. Who knew you could make so many amazing things with so little? So today I'm gonna be showing you three recipes that I wrote down a couple days ago. I was brainstorming for a solid week about this because I had a comment that requested that I do a video like this, which just goes to show, leave me some comments and I will listen, people. Before I get started, be sure to hit that subscribe button just so you can come back and see the episodes I post every week for you guys, especially during this tough time where I hope you're all remaining safe, healthy. So let's get started. Our first recipe is banana bars. So I have an 8x8 glass baking dish. I have sprayed and preheated my oven to 350 degrees. Now I have 4 cups of oats that I'm going to add 6 ripe mashed bananas to, as well as a cup of either peanut or almond butter. I am using almond butter, but it is totally up to you. Now this is as close to banana bread as we can get without it being bread, so they're more like protein bars, but they're great, healthy, and delicious. So give that a mix. If you want to add some semi-sweet chocolate chips, go for it. I can't resist, so I went ahead and did that, even though it's technically 4 ingredients now. That's okay. Just distribute this evenly into your dish and bake at 350 degrees for 20 to 25 minutes until they are nicely golden brown and set. You want to let these cool for about 15 minutes before cutting and serving. Now our second recipe is going to be 3-ingredient peanut butter cookies. So I have a sheet pan lined with parchment paper. Oven is still at 350 degrees. Now in a large bowl, I've got a cup of granulated sugar with a 1 large room temperature egg and a cup of creamy peanut butter. Just mix that together till it's nicely combined, and I am going to be using a 1.5-inch cookie scoop here to just scoop these onto my tray. Only a couple inches apart, they don't really spread. Now, if you want the traditional pattern on top, you can use a fork and do this cute little cross pattern on each one. That's the quintessential peanut butter cookie mark there. So, of course, we're gonna do that. It makes them just a little prettier. You wanna bake these at 350 for 10 to 12 minutes until they are just golden brown around the edges and on the bottoms. Let them set up and cool for about 10 minutes before you dig into these. Now our third and final recipe is going to be this easy chocolate sauce. So I have 12 ounces of semi-sweet chocolate chips in a heat-proof bowl over simmering water and 1/2 cup of heavy cream. You just want to stir this gently and occasionally over your low heat until it is nicely melted and combined. Then off the heat, add 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, and that is all it takes to make a delicious chocolate sauce that you can use for whatever you like. I'm going to be using mine on ice cream because I think that is the best way to enjoy this chocolate sauce for what it is. But honestly, folks, you can put this on anything you like, keep it in the fridge, and reheat it whenever you are ready to use it. And I mean, come on, how could you possibly resist that?
And we're back. You know, like I said, who knew you could make 3 amazing things? With only 3 ingredients. This has been part 4 of my 3 easy desserts series. I'm really trying to give you guys all the options possible here, given the circumstances and limited supplies at the stores. The links for the recipes for these are gonna be in the description below, so go check that out. Once again, please hit that subscribe button so you can come back and see what I post every week for you guys. Also, leave me some comments, hit that thumbs up button because we should be friendly. I hope you guys have a fantastic rest of your day. Thanks so much for joining me. Continue to stay safe and healthy and happy. Bake up a storm with me, and I'll see you next time.